Hello, I'm Dr. Sanjay Chaturvedi, advocate, editor, Real Estate Law Journal, and Maharashtra Corporate Housing Society Times. I'm going to speak to you today about the conveyance of societies. Very, very burning topic, and you and I know that without conveyance, you know, first let us understand why conveyance is required and why it is so very important. It is like this. Suppose you are driving a car and on the RC book somebody else's name is there. So you don't own it. So to own your society's own land, you must have the conveyance. So whenever you go to major repair, taking a permission from the BMC, or you want to go and, you know, start a redevelopment process of your society, then the conveyance is absolute required in the name of the society. There are so many rules, regulations in MADA, in CIDCO, and in repair boards, in such buildings where the government has offered, or even collector's land, the government has offered the societies to come forward and take the conveyance. Or sometime we have forgotten that whether the conveyance is on the name of the society or no. So the best way to identify that, just take the property card of the society or the property tax bill and see that whether your name is there on the property tax bill or no. If it is not, then it is a major concern. You must have the conveyance in your name. And having conveyance in your name, you must also ensure that your name should also be there on the property card. So that is the last step which we are going to speak, that why your name should appear on the property card. Let's see that the conveyance, so you understand what the conveyance important is. The conveyance of the society is very important. Government of Maharashtra has come up with a deemed conveyance. Now in deemed conveyance, also where the other party is not giving you a conveyance. Conveyance is a transfer of title from one person to another person. So if the developer in MOFA, it is MOFA is Maharashtra Apartment for Flat Ownership Act, in that the builder is duty bound to give the conveyance to the society within 4 months of the receiving of the OC, or it is within now 3 months in RERA that a developer must convey the conveyance to the in the name of the society. Now in conveyance part, let us see that how we should get a conveyance. In two scenarios, one is when your developer is ready to give you a conveyance. You trace him, you ask him that it is a criminal liability on the developer's part if he is not giving a conveyance to the society. So you can sue him in the MOFA court, ask the developer in the to give you a conveyance. If suppose you don't want to go in legal SL or whatever, you ask the developer, and if he is ready, then okay, you take the conveyance in the name of the society. So very easy process is this, that you must first appoint a advocate who will draft a conveyance deed in between the builder and you. Now between the builder and you, that means you means the society, the conveyance deed will be drafted citing that how the developer got or builder got the conveyance in his name, whether it is a development agreement, whether it is other joint development agreement, whether the developer himself or builder himself owns a particular plot. So in that particular plot, if he suppose is owning, suppose he himself owning it, so the one who owns it only can give you a conveyance. So if having only development agreement, then the landlord or whosoever to whom he has taken, or in within the development agreement, if the landlord has given the right to convey the land to the new society, then he can have conveyed that particular land to you. Now what is the procedure? The procedure is very simple. The advocate would go and ensure that what document you require society's DP remark, society's property card, you require society's registration certificate, you require society's membership register, and a very important one is that whether all the members have paid the stamp duty and registered their documents in and paid the registration fees. Now, if the registration is document is done, stamp duty is paid, then you will only for 500 rupees you can get it conveyed. You just collect all this information, go to the adjudicating officer, take his adjudicating stamp duty order. There is nothing remaining to be paid. Then go to the authorities to collect, and then your conveyance will be registered with the sub-registrar of assurance, and with only 500 rupees you can do it. Suppose in the members you are having say 50 members, out of 50 members 5 members have not paid the stamp duty, then they have to pay the stamp duty at present rate with all the liabilities and penalties and everything. Suppose 5 members or 2 members, in they are not original members, they have taken or purchased from some successive or previous members. So one particular flat is sold for 2, 3, 4, 5 times, and this in chain there is some one or two agreements are not paid the stamp duty, then the existing member has to pay the stamp duty and get it cleared. So this is what it is required. Once it is registered, then go to the city survey office and change the property card, on the property card the name of the society. So it is very simple. Deemed conveyance is also similar, having the process, but in this particular case where the developer is not there, you need some 2-3 more documents, say maybe affidavit and other forms which the government of Maharashtra has introduced, and in that manner deemed conveyance also. But deemed conveyance is not a good conveyance, but I believe so when the ultimately when the society's name is there on the property card, that means the conveyance is properly done and the title is transferred. Do visit us and subscribe us on this channel, or come to our website, that is housingsocietytimes.com, and there are so many books on various aspects of societies, like car parking, like society conveyance or self-redevelopment, and there are so many other landmark judgments on societies matters. So such type of books are available. Do subscribe to them, and happy viewing. Thank you very much.